Okay, now over to the crane collapse. We've got Wendell Edwards on the scene live with new information for us. Wendell, tell us.
And new pictures, Paul. Take a look behind me. I'm in the backyard here, just behind Deaconess Hospital. You can see the crane right here fell through this fence, and now it's in this backyard, right in this residence backyard. I can tell you what, here's what we know. A driver who was operating the crane was trying, along with the crew, to replace a cooling unit. You can see the air conditioning unit right there. This was a mobile crane. It had 10 gallons of fuel spilled. Hazmat is also happy here on the scene cleaning it up. We're understanding, though, that this was just an accident. The driver right now is also being checked out just as a precaution. Three cars were also told were damaged, as well as the property here on the resident side, right behind Deaconess Hospital on the northwest side. But again, but take a look at the wheels up of the crane over there. You can see that it's on its side. This is the second crane that they were using as well. I'm told the first one somehow malfunctioned too as well. And then this crane collapsing right here in this man's backyard, this owner's backyard, going through the fence. And I'm told this fence is only 4 months old. It was just replaced by the hospital. Looks like it's going to have to be replaced again. That's the latest from the northwest side behind Deaconess. I'm Wendell Edwards for KOCO Eyewitness News 5.
Wendell, thank you. Fortunately, nobody hurt in that incident there. So these late-breaking stories, we're going to continue to follow them. It does look like the grass fire is under control. There are still some answers we're looking for there on the crane collapse, so we'll keep that updated as well. We're going to update you here if we need to. We'll keep it at KOCO.com. We're also tweeting about it and Facebooking about it as well.